Why encryption backdoors are a horrific idea. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. One of the phrases you may have heard in recent years is encryption backdoor. The concept is actually very simple. Government agencies want to be able to monitor otherwise encrypted communications. The concept is fundamentally flawed. The fundamental concept of encrypted communications is that only the sender and the recipient can read the message exchanged between them. The sender encrypts it before sending, and only the recipient has the ability to decrypt it. One example I run into regularly is sending someone a password. If you don't want someone in the middle to be able to see it, an end-to-end encrypted messaging service is one solution. Governments don't like this at all. At its most basic, encryption prevents law enforcement from monitoring potentially illegal activities. At its most extreme, it prevents oppressive governments from monitoring what their citizens might be up to. As a result, from time to time, we hear of proposed legislation to force service providers to provide a backdoor that would allow authorized entities, such as the government, perhaps others, to access otherwise inaccessible communications. So, how might a backdoor work? Well, traditional encryption works in one of two ways. One method uses a common secret, like a password, which is used to both encrypt and then decrypt the data. The other method uses a key pair. One key can decrypt data encrypted by the other, and vice versa. Without the appropriate password or key, encrypted data cannot be decrypted. What both of these approaches have in common is math. Lots and lots of advanced, complicated math. A backdoor adds more math. In addition to the password or key, some kind of master key would also be able to decrypt the data. That master key would be shared only with trusted entities, like governments, with hopefully legitimate reasons to decrypt the data. Okay, all that's so much concept and math, all right? Let's have a look at a real-world physical example, because we've been using one for years. The TSA-approved padlock. In the United States, the TSA, Travel Security Administration, I think it is, they're the folks that are responsible for screening us as we get onto airplanes and x-raying our bags and doing whatever. They have mandated that only approved padlocks that also have an additional master key slot can be used on your baggage. The master key is a back door, allowing them to bypass your padlock's mechanism completely and open it. This allows them to examine the contents of your luggage. You can use a non-compliant padlock, but then the TSA has the right to break the lock. Now, there's a reasonable argument that this contributes to public safety. However, even though it's likely illegal to possess, the master key has long been available to anyone who cares to get it. Travelers have been forced to sacrifice personal privacy for public security. Now, the main difference between our physical example and encryption is the bolt cutter. Luggage locks are easily broken. Even the most secure locking mechanism can typically be thwarted with enough skill or force. That's not quite the same as digital encryption. An appropriately strong encryption algorithm can be practically impossible to break. Again, governments don't like this. They would very much like a way to break the lock, so to speak, of digital encryption. So, encryption backdoors are not just a bad idea, they're a horrific idea. To begin with, we would have to trust the government to hold the master key completely. That means they would have sufficient security in place to prevent the key from being stolen. They would have sufficient security in place to prevent the key from being copied. They would only use the key in appropriately legitimate circumstances. Every single employee of the entity holding a backdoor key would have to be trusted completely. TSA master keys have already failed the first two tests. The master key is readily available. Just like the TSA master key, the chances of an encryption master key being leaked are very, very close to 100%. Besides which, the back door may not even increase public safety. The problem? Good encryption already exists. Even in extreme cases where encryption backdoors are mandated and the use of non-backdoored encryption is outlawed, criminals will still use uncrackable encryption to render any backdoors the new algorithms have pointless. Honestly, I don't understand why this conversation, this aspect of the situation, isn't in more of the conversations on this topic. Criminals will continue to use sufficiently secure encryption, regardless of what is mandated. If good encryption is outlawed, then only outlaws will use good encryption. The password I shared with someone? With a backdoor, anyone with the backdoor key could still see it if so inclined. The only way I have to ensure that that isn't possible is to keep using non-backdoored encryption, legal or otherwise. Encryption with backdoors just doesn't make sense. Those who use it run the real risk of having their privacy violated. Those who understand it avoid it and take their communications elsewhere. And criminals naturally avoid it and continue to use more secure methods, legal or otherwise, to communicate. It's an ineffective approach to security that decreases the privacy of honest individuals. So why am I telling you this? I want you to understand the discussion when you hear or read about it. However, if you are in the United States or wherever this is being considered and you're able to communicate your thoughts to your elected officials, that's an opportunity. That is something that I think you should do. Let them know how pointless the effort really is. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/175446. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.